in your textbook on page 497 is the bell curve. And the area under this curve gives us a percent or a probability of an event occurring. If you know the mean will be at the center of the curve, and one standard deviation above the mean, 34% of the data fall there. Above one standard deviation of the mean, 16% of the data falls, because from the mean, half of the data will be above, half of the data will be below. So 50% of the data is above the mean, and 50% of the data is below the mean. So between the mean and one standard deviation, 34% of the data falls. Between the mean and two standard deviations, 47.5% of the data falls. And between three standard deviations and the mean, you get 49.85% of the data fall. Now we could look at that differently in terms of above two standard deviations would be the sum of these two numbers, which is 2.5. So 2.5% of the data fall above two standard deviations. Above three standard deviations, 0.15% of the data falls. Now if we look on below the mean, 34% is between the mean and one standard deviation below. Between the mean and two standard deviations, 47.5% of the data fall. And between the mean and three standard deviations, we have 49.85% of the data fall. And so now looking at it again this way, if you are below three standard deviations of the mean, then you're 0.15% of a chance being three standard deviations below the mean. So if you're looking at two standard deviations below, we have to add these two numbers together, and it would be 2.5%. If you want below one standard deviation, the mean, we add these three numbers together, and we get the percent of being below. And then if you're exactly halfway, you're at the mean, 50% is below, and 50% is above. Now, the reason I went over this bell curve is in question number 6 of your work, you had to calculate the percent that is above a number and the percent that is below a number. So what you have to do on that is use the z-score. So the z-score gives you the number of standard deviations that you are away from the mean. So you were given a mean of 260, a standard deviation of 3, and you were wondering if you had a value of 251, you see that's below the mean. So the standard deviation that we find is going to be negative because it's on the left side of the mean. So in using the z-score, we will take our data value of 251 minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. So the z-score is 251 minus 260 is negative 9 over 3. So the z-score is negative 3. Now what that means in terms of the normal curve is that the mean is here as 260 and the number 251 is 3 standard deviations below the mean. Now in looking at the book, it tells us that if you are 3 standard deviations below the mean, you only have a 1/1000th percent chance of being in this region. Now, in the problem that you are given on number 6, it says that if you are below 251, then you have a defective part. So that means that the probability of having a defective part or being below 251 would just be 1/1000th percent. Then you are looking at the probability of being above 263, because if you're above 263, then you also have a defective part. So you have to take your z-score, the data value, minus the mean, divided by the standard deviation. So 3 minus 3 is 1. So you're 1 standard deviation above the mean because it's positive, and because 263 is greater than the mean, so you know that you're going to be above the mean, and you're 1 standard deviation above the mean. Now, looking back at your textbook, you knew that from here to here is 34%, and you know that from the mean up is 50%, or half your data is from the mean up, and from the mean to 1 standard deviation is 34%. So 34 away from 50 would be 16% would fall above 1 standard deviation, or 16% of the items would be defective. So you have a 1/1000th percent and you have a 16% for that. So hopefully that helps you in thinking about what's happening in problem 6 on Connect.